Hey smart people, Toby Salami here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can build a dynamic component. A component is already dynamic, so if you're calling it a dynamic component, then there has to be something more in it, something beyond the stretch of human imagination, right? And you'll be right, because I'm about to show you just how you can do that. If you have no idea how any of this works, stay tuned for all of the parts of this series. You're going to understand in a bit. But for this one, let me show you what I intend to build here. It's a simple component, a simple listing of hotels. This is a hotel, Suri, this one too, Duri. The two hotels that are very unpopular because they do not exist. But the point is not that. The point is this. If you come inside of the editor, the way I created these two listings are as components. And if you notice here, you have the location, which is Africa, for Duri, and inside of this one for Suri, you have the location Asia. And that's okay. But what if we want to change this? What if we want to show hotels in Europe? So let's say Europe hotels, for example. All right. So how do we change this to show a hotel that is in Europe? We simply come inside of hotel location here and type in the slug of the term in which the hotel is listed. Here is how it works. If I come in here and paste in Europe, you see this changes to Uri, and that makes sense. Now, under new hotels, you have this showing us something from Africa. If we change this to Asia, for example, it quickly queries and shows us something else. Now, all of this is based on just one query. But how did I make this so smooth that you're itching to watch the first part of this unlimited number of series? Well, let's see it in the front end if this actually works. Let's refresh and see if it shows us our hotels. So in Europe, we see it shows us the hotel Uri, and in new hotels, it shows us Suri. You're going to learn how to apply this, so you want to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notifications right now because you don't want to miss any video that's part of this series or any video coming in the future. So let me show you how I got this done, shall we? So let's take a look at the plugins. The only plugin you really need here is JetEngine. Every other plugin here really doesn't matter, including the page builder. Whether you make use of Elementor or Bricks or Gutenberg, you can achieve the exact same thing I'm about to show you. I'm going to use Elementor in this case to demonstrate this, but please follow me if you use any other page builder. The first thing you want to do is to create a simple query. But before we create that query, let's take a look at how I have set things up here. I have a simple hotels CPT, and that's what you see right here. As you can see, you have a number of notable hotels all around the world. Uri, Suri, Muri, Juri, and Duri. Have you heard of them before? I have. All of them are linked to the locations taxonomy. So I have taken the time to connect all of the hotels to different locations, which are just simply terms. Now, the next thing I want to do is to create a simple query of hotels, the way you know it. So let's just come inside of JetEngine, come to Query Builder, open that in a new tab, and add a new query. The query we want to add is a simple query of posts because hotels are posts. So let's call this query of hotels on the site. Whatever we call it here, doesn't matter. We're going to come down here to where we have post type and specify that it's hotels. Next, you want to select the post status as published, and that will be all you do for now, except maybe you can just add a simple rule here. When you come under pagination, you want to select that it is one post per page. In other words, I only need this to return one post. I'm going to tell you why I did that in a bit, so just follow me. For now, let's just preview results and see what we have here. We have only one post returned, as you can see. That one post here, it really doesn't matter which post it returns because we're going to make all of this dynamic. And the way to do that would first be to add this query. Now, once you have this query added, we're ready for the next step. The next step will be to create a listing based on this query, a simple listing as you know it. So let's just create that. You already know how to do this. Let's go through it very quickly. Once you come to listing source, you want to select Query Builder. Under Query, you want to select that query we just created, which is Query of Hotels on the site, and you want to come to the listing item and give it a name. For now, I'm just going to call it Listing of Hotels. We're going to click on Create Listing Item, and we're going to add the items to the listing. Whatever we want to add to this listing is our choice. For now, what I choose to add are just two things. One is the post title, and second is, what do you think I should add? What do you think? Maybe the date. That's all. Let's come back inside of the listing and add a simple container. Inside of here, we're just going to add a heading widget. The heading widget will carry the title, of course. So let's just style it a bit so it looks a bit more visually appealing. And we're going to come to the dynamic tag option here and select post title. Of course, that's going to return the actual post title on the front end. But for now, let's just return the date. So we're just going to come here and select dynamic field and drag that inside of there. And on the object field, we're going to select the date. And that looks however it looks. I don't care about how it looks right now. What I really care about now is just to add a simple background color, maybe white, and give it a simple padding of maybe 20 pixels. And that should be all right. Except maybe I can also add a little border radius here of 16. We're okay. We're fine. Anything more than this is overkill. Once we've created our listing, the next thing we want to do is close it out because we don't need it anymore. What we need now is to come back inside of listings and components. And this time, we're going to create a new component. So let's click on add new component. And for the component, we're just going to give it a name of our choice. So we're just going to write component hotels. Something like that should be fine. And let's just click on create component. Now, what does a component do? I'm pretty sure you know this already. You can basically control whatever you want to control inside of that component. Let's see how that works. If you come to the settings icon here, I mean, if you make use of Bricks Builder or Gutenberg, you should find it somewhere in the interface. I trust you too. I trust you. Come inside of here to component content controls. And this is where you add the different controls for the items inside of the component. Items like what? For example, I want to control the post ID or the hotel ID, if I can call it that. Each of these hotel items are actually posts as you know them. So let's try to edit one of them and see if they actually have a post ID. Look at that in the URL there. That's it. So that's the post ID. Let's say that we want to show just one of the hotels at a time on the website, but we want to make it also dynamic. If you're getting confused, you shouldn't. So just stay with me, okay? You get it. Now, come inside of the component and let's change the control label here to hotel ID. And inside of the control name, please keep this in mind. Whatever you type in here will be very important. In fact, after we type it in, we're just going to copy it for use later. So control name, we're just going to select here hotel ID. Something that will not have a space inside of it should be good. Now, hotel ID, excellent. Control type, let's leave it as text for now. Inside of default value, let's give it a default value of maybe 539, something we want to show already when we select the component. So let's select 539 here. That should be okay. Next, we want to select hotel slug. So we're just going to come inside of the control label and write hotel slug. It is going to return one item inside of a particular hotel location. Maybe we can call this hotel location then, just so we can remain on the same page. We're going to select one item inside the location that's going to be shown anywhere we want it to show on the website. Once we have hotel location written, we want to write the control name. Again, something without spaces. Hotel location. We're going to copy that too because we're going to need it soon. Now, the hotel location should be a slug. So we can put it in brackets here, slug, just so whoever is going to be editing that component knows what to type in there. Now, we can leave the control type too as text because the slug technically is text. Let's look for something we can use as the default one. If we come inside of locations here, we see a number of different locations and we see the number of count items here, which means they have some items attached to them. Hotels in Africa, for example. For Africa, the slug here is Africa. So let's just copy that. And we're going to come inside of the component and write inside of the default value Africa. That should be okay. Now, if all of this isn't making sense just yet, I implore you to just hold on. Hold your horses. Let's come inside here and add a simple container. Now, once we're done, we're gonna add inside of here a listing, the listing grid we previously created. So let's just add that inside of here. Now in the listing, we're just gonna select the hotel listing we previously created there. Let's keep the column number as 1, and you recall in the query that we specified that there should only be one item returned to us in this query. So this makes absolute sense that we have just one item here. Now that we have this here, voila, we're done. We need to come inside of here and simply click on publish. We're simply done. Almost. Let's come back inside the editor here and simply refresh the editor, because now we just created a component that we can find inside of our list of widgets. This applies in Bricks and it also applies in Gutenberg. If you come inside of the widgets now and simply search for the hotel component there, you see the component hotels. You can drag this inside of here and you see you have a simple component right there. Let's ensure that this fills the entire width of the page, so we're just going to set it to full width. Now, let's come back inside content. We have two things here, the hotel ID and the hotel location. Let us assume that we want to change the hotel ID to something else and we want to specify a different location here. We can do that. We can come back inside of the hotels here and let's say we want to select a different hotel. Let's say jury, for example, and click on edit. Once we edit that, we can see inside of the URL what the hotel ID is, 543. We can copy that. We can come back inside of here and let's close this one out. We're gonna come back inside of the editor and select the hotel ID and paste it inside of there. Now, it doesn't change the query here, does it? The name Suri still remains, but that's not what it is here. What's here is jury, right? So it means we have to find a way to connect the hotel ID with the query that loads this listing item inside of here. And we also need to make sure that whatever we add as the hotel location slug here determines this query. To do that is quite simple. You recall that for both of these component controls, we copied their names. So let's go ahead and edit our query. First, let's hit publish here and come back inside here to the dashboard and edit the query we previously created. Our reason now for doing this is because we want to edit and add the component controls inside of our query so that whatever we select inside of the component here really does affect what shows inside of the component. So to do that, let's edit the query. Let's scroll all the way down here to where we have tax query. Now let's add a new tax query. And inside of taxonomy, we want to, of course, select locations because that's the what we specified here inside of the component, right? Let's come back inside of query builder and we're going to select the field slug. Now inside of terms, here is where it is expecting us to add the slug. But instead of just typing in the slug here by, you know, copying Africa, for example, and pasting it inside of here, we're going to click on this control item here and select component control value. It's the stuff at the top right here. Once you drop that in there, you want to add the control name. What we added as the name here was hotel location. Do you recall? Yes. We want to add that and click on apply. Now inside of compare operator, we want to select in. Good. Good. We're almost done. Now that we're done with that, we're going to come back here inside of post per page and we're going to specify the post ID. As you can see here, post ID, get post by ID. This field can only take one ID at a time. If you want to add multiple IDs, maybe separated by commas, you want to do that inside of here. For now, we need just one ID. So let's select here the component control value once again. And here we're just going to type in hotel ID. That's, of course, what the control name was, if you recall. Click on apply and you're ready to go. Once you click on update query, we can come back inside the editor and let's refresh so that the new query that we just edited can now take effect. The next thing you want to do is test this to make sure it works. As you can see here, because of course the hotel ID here is 543, you see it's selected as jury. Let's come back here inside of hotels and try it with a different hotel. Let's say, for example, Muri. And we're going to select Muri and select 541, since that's, of course, the post ID. Once we select that, we can come back inside the editor here and type that inside of there, 541. As you can see there, Muri. Excellent. Beautiful. If we take off the hotel ID and let's try to use the hotel location alone, you can see now it returns just one item from Africa, which is Duri. Let's try from Asia, for example. You see it returns Suri. That's awesome. That's marvelous. Because now whatever we have inside of here is technically controlling the component query. This means, therefore, that we can have maximum control of our design on the website. For example, we can add another heading inside of here, a simple heading, and maybe type in here our show hotels. Let's just make it look somewhat decent. And let's duplicate this container and write new hotels. You know? Something else. Now imagine that someone who is a designer and is actually not a developer, doesn't know his way around queries, has to do something just like this. The person can very easily make changes to the query without editing the query. One query to rule them all. We're going to select here inside of here this hotel and maybe type in here Africa. Inside of here, you see it returns the item Duri. And just like that, you can very easily make your components dynamic and all your components based on one single query to rule them all. This is simple. And if we hit publish and come to the front page and refresh this, we see now that two hotels show on the site with the same query. Now, if you're wondering what other situations can I apply this, stay tuned for part 2 of building a dynamic component. Let me know what you think about this in the comment section below. I'm eager to hear what you have to say. My name is Toby Salami as always, and until next time, my people, stay dynamic.